So our next story is called Little Tyke. Now, most of you are familiar with Auburn Mountain View High School, the fourth high school built in our city. It's located up on Lee Hill. And the interesting thing about that is that at the base of that hill, half a century before, there was a real lion that lived there. Now, the mother of this lion was captured in the wild, and she was held in captivity at Point Defiance Zoo. And every time she had a litter of cubs, she killed them all. Well, one day, one of the zookeepers managed to save one of the cubs when she had a new litter, and he gave it to a couple that lived in Auburn on the Green River at the base of Lee Hill. Now, they raised it to full adulthood, and some of the neighbors were fairly nervous because lionesses are the ones who do all the work, and they kill animals, and in wild, they'll kill people. But this lion was a vegetarian. They tried to get it to eat meat, never learned to eat meat, even when it was fully grown. And it lived on a ranch with horses, sheep, and other animals, and full-grown lion, very fierce-looking, and in fact, the city actually passed a law, directed it, Little Tyke, to prevent the owner from letting it walk loose in the city of Auburn. Well, Little Tyke was probably the first nationally famous citizen of Auburn. She appeared on a number of TV shows and actually helped put Auburn on the map. She died in 1955, just short of her ninth birthday. And I know there's people here who knew Little Tyke, and the ones that I know have all their hands or feet, so I guess the point about her being a vegetarian was true. So remember, when you think about the Auburn Mountain View Lions, Little Tyke was really the very first lion in Auburn.